Well, more than 100 cute baby turtles are now part of an experimental project in Anne Arundel County.
Yeah, it's a project where the term TERPS means much more than football or basketball teams to the kids involved in it. 11 News reporter Benjamin Mizell has that story.
They were in my office. To kids, these two guys are known as Little Steve and Big Barry. They're friends. For now, they're nicknamed the Squirts. It's the type of name-calling that's actually encouraged in Anne Arundel County schools.
It's one of the most motivating tools we've seen that teach about the environment.
Coming up with names for each of these two-week-old terrapins is just one part of a new hands-on project that teaches elementary students all about turtles, from learning how each one is unique.
That's their fingerprint.
To figuring out how turtles swim, mate, and eat.
We've seen, even with fourth graders or four-year-olds, that we've seen them do data comparison and data analysis.
In essence, what happens is the terrapin becomes the window or the vehicle by which kids learn about the Chesapeake Bay.
Before these baby terrapins were captured, their survival rate was only 1%, but as they continue to grow, that rate goes up. Between now and next spring, 160 quarter-sized terrapins are expected to grow under the watchful eye of school kids into the size of a Big Mac hamburger.
Now that's extraordinary growth, and it's because they're in tanks with heated water, special lighting, and of course they're fed as much food as they need.
It wasn't long ago when Steve and Barry were expected to become food themselves.
These two were rescued. They were actually taken from a very sick turtle that was taken from the market.
Now that they've been nursed back to health, they'll each be dispersed to 70 different classrooms, where kids have no intention of making them soup, but only want to watch them play and grow.
So the terrapin becomes the vehicle for learning. So the kids learn, if I take care of the Chesapeake Bay, I'm in a way taking care of my terrapins once they're released.
And making sure Little Steve and Big Barry always have a safe place to call home. Reporting Mindy Mizell, WBAL-TV 11 News.